Have you ever tried to do a screen recording on your Mac and realized it was not possible to capture the audio that's playing back on your system? Well, today I'll show you exactly how to do it at no cost. Let's get going. By the end of this video, you'll know how to capture internal audio while you're doing a screen recording for free. I'll show you every single step and all the links will be in the description. So let's get going. The first thing you're gonna need to do is download a free audio plugin for Mac called Black Hole. The website is called existential.audio/blackhole. So once you open that website, you click donate $10, or you can click also I can't afford to donate. Then you put your information. Next thing you're gonna have is a download link that they're gonna provide. So you can either download a 2-channel, 16-channel, or 64-channel version. It doesn't really matter. Let's download the 2-channel version of it. Then you'll install the virtual audio driver. And after that, you may need to reboot your computer. So after installing Black Hole, which was the first step, the second thing we're gonna do is go in Finder, Applications, Utilities, and then here, Audio MIDI Setup. So here in Audio MIDI Setup, you're gonna see all the devices connected to your computer, and you're gonna also see here Black Hole 2-channel, okay? So if you're using an additional external microphone, let's say you're recording a podcast or something like that, you're gonna need to create an audio aggregate device. If you're not using any external device, in this case as an additional audio input, if you just want to capture your system audio, you can skip this step. But for those of you who want to record external signal like USB mic, you're gonna need to create an aggregate device. So here, you're gonna click on the lower left corner on the plus, and you're gonna click create aggregate device. So the first step is very important. Click on Black Hole 2-channel that you can see here as your first device. And then whatever other device you want to add to your aggregate device, you can click. So for example, if you have an iMac, there's a built-in microphone in there, you can click built-in microphone. So you see here appearing your built-in microphone, and you're gonna be able to add this as an additional audio input to your QuickTime recording that we're gonna be doing right after that. So here, since I'm not using the built-in audio input, I'm gonna select my audio interface's input in case I want to record with a microphone here. The third step that's important is gonna be to create a multi-output device. Again, it's on the left lower corner of Audio MIDI Setup. You're gonna create multi-output device. Very important here, the first thing that you're gonna select is built-in output as your first device. And then you're gonna select Black Hole 2-channel. So after having created this multi-output device, now the audio will come out of your usual output, meaning your speakers or your headphones, but will also be sent internally to QuickTime via Black Hole Audio Loopback Driver. So before going to QuickTime Player, what we're gonna do here is rename our devices. Multi-out device, let's rename it to Screen Record. Screen Record Out. And aggregate device, let's rename it QuickTime Input. Now, our fourth step before getting started with the screen recording, you're going to go to System Settings, you're gonna go to Sound, and in the Output section, and here we're gonna have Screen Record Out selected, and we'll minimize this window because we'll return to it later. So here we're done, we're gonna quit Audio MIDI Setup. The next thing we're gonna do is go in Applications, and you're gonna go QuickTime Player. So here, QuickTime Player is open. We're gonna go to File and click New Screen Recording. So this is pretty straightforward at this point. The only thing we're gonna do is click Options here. And what's very important is that here you're gonna select QuickTime Input. If you don't have additional external devices that you want to use, let's say an external USB mic, you can simply leave Black Hole 2-channel and the screen recording will record internal audio perfectly. But in this case, we created an aggregate audio device to be able to have multiple inputs at the same time. So we'll click to QuickTime Input, and the next thing you're gonna have to do is simply click Record and select display one as your main display if you have multiple displays. And here we go. So right now we're screen recording. So to test if everything works, we're gonna go on YouTube and we're going to click royalty free music. Here we have royalty free music, so we'll play it. Then we're going to go to QuickTime. We're going to stop the recording, and here we're going to be able to hear the audio that was recorded through YouTube via Black Hole in QuickTime. Now that we've made the test and that you can see you could capture system audio, the only thing that we need to do is go back to system setting and put back your default output for sound. If you encounter any issue along the way, just ask me in the comments and I'll try to answer as soon as possible. If this video was helpful, please click like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. See you again very soon.